Welcome back, everybody! I found nothing in there. Nothing in that place that we ended off last episode. It was unfortunate, but it is what it is. But either way, we are going back to where we were going before. It's gonna be great. Probably. I didn't mean to do that. I meant to open up the map. So, let's see. We've got... Oh, okay. So, we got that. So, anyway, it looks like that's probably where we're going. Probably. So, I want to go over here then, because there's a code red demon, gosh dang it! Gotta find him. Why I say so crazy like that? I don't know. I felt like it a little bit. But no, seriously though, gosh, freaking dang it. We gotta do some things. We gotta fight some enemies. No, we're not really gonna fight any enemies. I mean, we might, but I'm not gonna try to fight enemies. That's not the goal. The goal today is some exploration. And then climb the promising mountain in search of the Earthpulse point. Because that's what we need to do. I mean, you've seen it before. And you'll certainly see it again. You'll just keep on seeing things and seeing more things. Did that say 13 Tales coins I just got like a few seconds ago? I have no idea. That seems like a lot though. I'm used to getting smaller numbers than that. That is a cat's chest. It's a cat's chest, everyone. Do we have enough? We have enough. That's also a lot. 225. Not a cats. Boy Norman had eyes and... Oh, I see. Boy Norman head for eyes and the black color, steadfast as the man himself. Oh, and then there's the suit. Alright. Well, we obviously know what that's going to look like. I think April Fool's is kind of passed by at this point, unfortunately. That was actually one thing. I don't know if I mentioned this or not already. If I did already, well, whatever, I'm saying it again, I suppose. I actually wanted to do it a certain way. I wanted to make it where everyone was wearing a different color. But unfortunately, it didn't work out that way. I had Eleanor and Velvet in the same costume. They were both wearing the Boy Norman costume set. Which was unfortunate. I didn't want that to happen. Is there a chest up there? Did I really miss a chest up there? Come on now. Regardless, though, I wanted to do it that way, because I thought... That would just make sense. Why is there gotta be a path here? I don't want to go back in this direction. I really do not want to go back in this direction. Yeah, I wanted them all to have different things. Like, there was a Wind Norman costume. There was a Void Norman, Fire Norman, Water Norman. There was an Earth Norman, which I think the Earth Norman was the only one I didn't actually have on me at that time, on any characters whatsoever. I forget who had that available, though. I could have purchased it for someone, but I was too lazy to actually try and do that. I don't know why. Maybe I was just like, you know, whatever. I'm just gonna do this. Doesn't matter if we have two people in the same costume, I suppose. I think what I really wanted to avoid was having three people in the same costume. That was what I really wanted to avoid. That's why I kind of bought what I bought for Magilu, who I think was wearing the Wind Norman costume. I tried to buy some unique stuff, things that people didn't already have. So it kind of worked out in a way. Well, actually, no. What I prioritized first and foremost was actually to get people who didn't already have the costumes their costumes, which I did. And then if I felt the necessary things were needed to buy some other things, then I did. Man, but yeah, in a perfect world, everyone would have been wearing a different costume, but that wasn't what happened. But it was good enough. And in one way, it kind of wasn't too bad either, because, you know what, it might make it a little bit confusing for all of you. I mean, who doesn't like a little bit of random confusion? I like a little random confusion sometimes. Like, oh, who's actually saying this? Who is that? Which one is it? They're both wearing the same thing. Now, what I should have really done, I should have just had everyone in the same costume. Then you really wouldn't be able to tell who was who. I mean, at least I kind of gave you a little bit of a hint as to who was who. Because, I mean, if you figure out what costume everyone's in, then you can figure it out pretty easily. Just like, oh, well, okay, well, Velvet's in the... Boy Norman costume, so is Eleanor. So it's gotta be one of those two. Process of elimination, you know, haha. And then, of course, everyone else, like, you know, you just figure it out right away and you don't have to really think about it too hard. But you have everyone in the same costume, like, oh, I don't know why I thought it was a cat's chest for a second there. I don't know, it was a cat's chest. Everyone in the same costume, you know, and oh boy, let the confusion get crazy. Yeah, I really should have done that. Maybe that's the mastermind plan. Just have everyone in the Bienfu costume. Not like I would have been able to do that, but. But that's the problem, though. Like, at this point in the game, maybe if I was a little later in the game, I could have been able to do it. But the problem was, like, you know, the freaking rib injury just had to derail things. I wasn't as far into the game as I would have liked by that point. Could have been I mean, who knows? I don't know how close I could have been to the end of the game at this point if I was not stopped. I mean, we're already over 50 episodes in. I mean, are we going to get to 100? That's the real question. It doesn't feel like we're really that close to the end at all. I mean, no surprise there. I mean, it says 41 hours and 57 minutes. I mean, I'm sure that is not how long I've actually been playing, because, well, I mean, I guess if you get rid of a little bit of off-screen messing around, that does add on to the time a little bit. But in terms of actual story, like, we're not that far, because it's only 50-some episodes. I don't know. Makes me wonder. Well, no, not really, I guess. Well, no, maybe more for, like, not for Symphonia. I was going to say, makes me wonder how I got through Symphonia so fast. Well, I mean, one, obviously I know the game really well. And two, I skipped all the freaking skits. Which, by the way, I'm just going to let you know, just in case I haven't already. What was I going to say? If I ever get back to that, which I do plan to eventually. I really do. I hope to at least have it out before the end of this year. Sometime in 2017, I would like to get the Symphonia bonus episode out. That's all I'm going to say. Oh, I don't think I got it off. But, yeah, I didn't get it off. At some point... Oh. Mogulu and Illinois don't have it. Okay, well, that kind of messed it up right away. But I was going to say, though... Thanks. Some point before the end of this year, I would like to get that bonus episode out. And then I would like to do a secondary bonus episode that is basically me showing all the skits in the entire game. Because I didn't do that in my original playthrough. That was kind of one of the unfortunate things about that. Because first starting out, I was like, oh, you know, I've already seen all these skits. And I guess I just wasn't really too eager on doing a bunch of voices for random characters, too. Well, not like the Symphonia cast a bunch of random characters, but you know what I mean. But I didn't want to just make a bunch of random voices for all these characters and have to do them all the time. It's just one of those things. You know, you just start out like, oh, well, I want to do something this way. And then later on, as you're getting more used to it, you realize, well, come to think of it, maybe I should have actually done it this way. Which I did do for, I believe it was Tales of the Abyss.
That was tougher than I would have liked.
Yeah, it was Tales of the Abyss. I did it for that game. I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna just, I'll voice all the skits in that game. Can't suppose one of the maximum souls of characters wearing equipment that's been enhanced. Oops. Whatever, I didn't mean to do that. But yeah, I did eventually learn my lesson when I played Tales of the Abyss. So I read all the skits in that game, because they were also not voiced, just like Symphonia was, unfortunately. But yeah, unfortunately, Symphonia, I didn't really do any of these skits in that game. I don't know what came over me during that time period. So long ago. It was more than 3 years ago now. It was a long time ago, when you really think about it. Well, sort of. I don't know. It feels like a long time ago, in a way. But at the same time, it also doesn't. I don't know, it doesn't really make any sense. But it feels like it was not that long ago, but at the same time, it does feel like it was that long ago. Like, a long time ago. Like, that long ago, I felt like I was actually a little smarter. Like, I feel like I've lost brain cells or something. Like, I got stupider over the last couple years. Which also doesn't make any sense, because I graduated college since starting this channel, so he was like, okay. Oh my gosh, the Earthpulse point is near that peak. Going any further, we'll take us away from it. Let's head to the mountain for now! Maybe a mountain we can take somewhere. Anyway, now that we killed that Code Red Demon and got a lot of treasure chests, and we got two left, I don't know where they are. Like, they could be off in the direction of the mountain, maybe. Maybe. We gotta be at least one over here, right? What is this? Oh, wait, no, this is a pathway. No, it's not. What? Never mind. Yeah, I forgot. I just went down the pathway and was like, oh, well, you can't go that way. Duh. See, like I said, I've gotten stupider. I used to be kind of decent at paying attention, honestly, in a way. Oh, wow, look at that. You remember how that happened? And then again, I was also playing a lot of non-blind games, too, so maybe that's another reason. Because I'm, like, reliving my childhood, basically. So I'm able to better observe these games that I've already played once upon a time. But with newer games, that's been mostly what I've been playing lately. When was the last time I played a non-blind game, actually? I don't know. I don't remember. I'm probably just completely blanking out and not remembering at all, because maybe there was something pretty recent, I'm just not even thinking about it right now, but regardless, it feels like it's been a while since I've last played a non-blind game, so therefore I'm kind of just experiencing a lot of these games for the first time ever, basically. Like, oh, wow, oh my gosh, this is what happens? No way! And then I don't really think about what happened later on. It's like one of those things, really, because you go back and play Symphonia, and it's like, oh wow, this happened that point in the game, and then you realize that's actually a hugely significant thing, and then your first playthrough, you don't even realize how significant that moment was, because it just happened so long ago, and then, I mean, you know, anyone who's played Symphonia more than once would realize there's plenty of moments like that where you're like, wow, that's why that happened, now I understand. Yeah, I don't know. I don't even know how many moments like that would really be in this game, to be honest. Maybe the situation with the Velvet Beak. No, not really. That wouldn't make any sense either, because they did explain that. So that's not really something you yourself would go back and realize, like, oh! You don't have that connecting point, really. No. I mean, maybe there could be something like that later on in the game. But what do I know? But regardless, though, going back to what I was saying, though, yeah, Symphonia was pretty quick because I didn't do any of those skits. It was like 40 episodes, I think, something like that, right? Abyss was something in the 60s, but if I had not done it, I didn't mean to do that. But if it was something, if I didn't do any skits in that game, too, it probably also would have been the 40s. But yeah, I'm just thinking, because Zestiri took something like 90 episodes. But again, we're talking about, I did view all the freaking skits in the game. I literally viewed all the skits in the game. Maybe not during the full playthrough I did all the skits in the bonus episode. But during the main playthrough, it was almost all the skits.
Hey, is everyone alright?
It was pretty close. I think I was only missing like a few dozen skits maybe. I don't know. It wasn't very much though. You know, just bought all the rest I was missing. Oh, there you go.
Yeah,
got them all?
I can really feel the earth pulse now. It's up above.
Guess we're in for some mountain climbing then.
Glad to know you're really feeling it, Lafayette. Glad to know you're really feeling it. Alright, it's up the mountain we go at long last, or maybe we just get an herb instead. Take some of that. I enjoy it a lot. And... okay, then I see. So wait, then we climb up some more, do we? And then this goes over here. This is the last treasure chest we were looking for! Feldspar boots, nice. Alright, so we found all of them. Very nice. I actually wasn't really sure if we were going to find all of them or not. We did! Pretty nice indeed. Oh, there was actually something I really wanted to do, too. I keep forgetting about this. I don't know. I kind of want to make this a separate video on one hand, but... like, I want... it's actually an interesting viewpoint. I kind of like this. There was one video I wanted to make. It was nothing special, really. Unrelated to the bonus episodes for Symphonia, but... I wanted to make a video, because speaking of 3 years... more than 3 years of doing this. Well, not great. I guess the cutscene that we're going to be doing is right here. I will do that in just a second. I'll walk... oh, wait a second. No, don't walk up to it. Don't walk up to it. You don't want to walk up to it. You'll start a thing that you don't want to start up, and then it's like, oh, no. Didn't mean to do that. Like, oh, wow, look at this viewpoint.
I can't wait to...
so before I go on to that, though, there was actually one thing. Maybe I'll do that eventually. You know what? Maybe I'll do that after this episode. I'll just be like, hey. Okay, this is what I'll say right now. What I wanted to do... I wanted to do this around my 3-year anniversary, actually. I forget why I didn't do it. I don't remember. Maybe because I was focusing on Valkyrie. No, that wasn't right. I don't remember, actually. But what I wanted to do... No. It wasn't my 3-year anniversary. It was around the start of the new year, which is actually pretty close to my 3-year anniversary. But what I wanted to do, though, I wanted to actually make a video where I was basically polling you guys. Because I love polls. I don't know why. I just like polls for some reason. But I want to make a poll that was like, what was your favorite series of 2014? What was your favorite series of 2015? What was your favorite series of 2016? I wanted to make a video like that. I actually wanted to make a video like that since literally the start of 2016, actually. But I just never got around to it for whatever reason. Then it's like, suddenly, oh, it's the middle of the year. So I was just like, I just kind of figured I'd just hold off until next year. And now I still haven't really done that. But maybe I will now. Who knows? I don't know. But regardless, I wanted to do that. I don't know. I'm kind of curious, though, because I know I kind of have my personal favorites. Well, I can't really just name it off the top of my head, but I have to see the list. But I know if I had the list right in front of me, I'd probably be like, oh, you know, that was my favorite series of that year. That was my favorite series of that year. But I would make this in the form of a poll because I'd want to hear from you, what did you think was your favorite series of that year? And then I'd be like, oh, wow. So apparently people had different favorites than I did. Of course, this is actually asking a very extremely limited number of people, too, because not everyone's watched all of my series But, eh, you know, whether you watch them all or not, you can still have a favorite, I suppose, so that's nothing wrong with that. Anyway, though, yeah, this is something I want to do. Maybe you'll see it sometime soon. Maybe you'll just even see it before this video comes out. I have friggin' no idea. Anyway, resume.
Take a good look around. Whoa, now that's what I call a view.
I agree that it's beautiful, but don't leap about so much. You'll fall. I can sense many earth pulses under this place.
I figured you'd notice that. An intricate web of earth pulses crisscrosses the land under the Aldina Plains. Mountains like these would normally take tens of thousands of years to form, but these popped up in about a millennia.
So the earth pulses have affected the land?
Exactly. Long ago, people wielded arts that allowed them to manipulate the earth pulses and control the very land itself.
How could arts like that exist?
Perhaps they pushed against key points on the earth pulses? Like how acupressure can improve a person's blood flow.
That's a rather forced comparison, but you may be right. Either way, those arts have been lost for eons.
I'm impressed, Aizen. You know a lot about everything.
Not at all. There's so much I don't know. For example, the name of these flowers. That's why I travel. To learn.
Aldina alabaster grass.
That's the name of this flower?
Yes. A long time ago, my brother showed me a picture of it in one of his books. They're fragile flowers. They die quickly on their own. But if enough of them gather together, they can survive. Fields of them form beautiful white carpets of flowers. In some cultures, they symbolize kinship. The bonds between people.
Kinship? Huh.
I'll remember that. You and your brother taught me something new today.
I'll never forget either.
I suppose not. I guess kind of finishing what I was saying, though, because I don't think I really finished what I was saying. We are over 50 episodes, basically. So, that's halfway to 100. And we still haven't had a 100-episode series yet. We've come close a couple times. Zestiria, Crack the 90s, Valkyria Chronicles 2, Crack the 90s. I think Valkyria Chronicles 2 was, like, what, 3 episodes away from 100, I want to say it was? I don't remember the exact number, so excuse me. But I think it was, like, 97, I want to say, something like that. So it came pretty close, but didn't get there.
Here! This is the Earth Pulse point I've been feeling!
But will this reach 100? Will this be the one to reach 100, though? You make your predictions, everyone. I was going to say... Don't say it if you've played the game, but just leave a comment if you think it's gonna do it or not. Or maybe I'll leave a poll here. Maybe I won't. I don't know. You tell me.
No Therian and no barrier. I must have gotten it wrong again.
I wouldn't be so sure of that. That dragon could well have broken its barrier. Or it might have been too powerful for the Abbey to subdue.
You could be right. After all, dragons make for the strongest demons.
The problem is, we don't know if it's a Therian or not.
Yeah. Let's stick with the plan and head to Stonebury to gather more information.
Am I the only one here who thinks the real problem is how we're supposed to fight a frickin' dragon?
Nah, come on now. I mean, we can fight it pretty easily. Just hit it a bunch with your mystic arts and then it's done. Game over. You beat it. Well, wait, where am I supposed to go now? Now here I thought this is going to be something crazy. But apparently not. I mean, this could still be the same location. I mean, it is 1,000 years in the past. And Aizen did just say that it doesn't take that long for these kind of mountain formations to form. So 1,000 years in the future, when Zestiria comes around, this place could be looking a lot different. Well, it still kind of looks the same, but... A lot different, even more rock formations in the area. I mean, it could. I don't know. I wouldn't know. I haven't seen how this place is formed. I haven't seen how this place is transformed over the 1,000 years. If it has at all, that is. Which it probably has. Freaking earth pulses. They really know how to make things happen, don't they? Am I supposed to go? Well, that doesn't really tell me where I should be going and where I shouldn't be going. I feel like the upper one's gonna be the one where I have to go through, though, so maybe... But maybe I'll go through the lower one. Alright, I'm gonna go to the lower one, everyone. That's how it's gonna be. Do you think it's right, or do you think it's wrong? I hope it's right. I really do. What am I talking about? I hope it's wrong. I want to go the wrong way first. Jeez. I can't even say the things that I want to say correctly right now. It's just like, hey, guess what? I want to go to the right place when it's really the wrong place. Honestly, the wrong place is the right place in my books here. Because I don't want to go to the right place. The right place is the wrong place. It's opposite day. Not really, but you know, you get the idea. You just don't want to do... You want to do the side stuff first. I like doing side stuff first. Do you like doing side stuff first, everyone? Let me know. I don't know. Side stuff is usually my preferred method of travel. Not travel. You know, whatever. I don't know. My preferred method of doing things. So it's over there somewhere, that other one. I don't remember actually seeing that one for some reason. Like, I just walked past it and didn't even see it. Maybe. I apparently missed that one. How could I miss that? How is that possible? I just realized I have 164 now. Was that back in the single digits? Or not single digits, double digits earlier? Like the 60s, I want to say. When did I get 100 more spirits? I feel like I just did something crazy. They both connect! That's amazing! My expedition returned! Alright! Congratulations on your 25-minute expedition. You've done well today. Good job, Aizen. Good job. For a second there, I thought that was leading me somewhere else. I was like, wow, this isn't even on the map. What am I supposed to do here? This area's bigger than it looks, isn't it? I'm just looking at my map indicator location. And it just looks like I'm not even moving very fast. I barely moved away from that little area. Barely. But yeah, I look like I'm right next to you on the map. Oh, man. Well... This is why I really wish we could move a little bit faster. Give me some more upgrades to my speed, please. Can I hack the game and get like triple speed or something? I would like that. Zoom across the land! We'll never know what's coming. Why am I even going in here? The Zamal Grotto, Den of Demons? Oh, I can't even go in here. Okay. Zamal Grotto is a den of powerful demons. Entry to this place has been forbidden. Can't stop me. Can't stop me, man. You're not allowed to. Seriously, why are they stopping me? Can't I just tell them, hey, you know what? I have official clearance to get in there now. You can't even possibly think to... Ooh, there's a treasure chest over there. I can see it. I'm gonna get it. And it's gonna be gotten. You're so far away, even though you look so close on the map. I don't like disproportionate maps. I prefer my maps being perfectly proportionate. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, if you look at it like this... I mean, look at that. That area looks so much like the same size almost. Oh, is there another one off the north? There is! I didn't even notice that. It's like right next to the treasure chest symbol. I didn't even notice it. That's kind of bad. It's kind of really bad, actually. And I'm just going to have to walk and walk and walk and walk you! Walk you, walk you, walk you! That just sounds wrong. Just say walk you. For no reason. There you go. You've been hit. There you go. You've been wide open. There you go. You've been killed. There you go. You've been killed again. And now that's it. Congratulations! You've done it! You're wide open? No, you're not wide open.
I won't improve by fighting weaklings.
That sounds new. I don't think you said that one before. At least I don't think so. I don't recall it. Do you recall it, everyone? Has he said that in the series yet? I don't think he has. Maybe he has. Maybe I don't remember. Sometimes it's hard to remember. Because every now and then when I'm fighting these enemies off screen, and I'm running the recording just to see if I can get some neat victory quotes, sometimes I'm just not even sure if it's ever if it's already happened or not. I'm like, oh, well, is this happened or not? Well, I might as well just include it in the video just in case. You never know. It might have happened, it might not have happened. I mean, it's like, it's just a few wasted seconds if I've already shown it once before. No big deal. And obviously, if it has been seen before, you can always tell me. And I'll know, like, oh, shoot, I guess I goofed up on that one. I guess I'll remember for next time, just in case I see it again. I'm like, oh, well, I've definitely seen that one before. We'll have to
think twice about it again. Oh, jeez.
All right. This is taking a long time to get around Western Aldina Plains. That leads me over... Wait a second. What? Oh. Well, it's nice to have a quick travel point anyway. Well, not really, actually. What am I talking about? I mean, I could just use this. I can use my knot bottles. I don't need these little circles to send me in another direction. You know, that's something I don't think I talked about with the 3DS, new 3DS I got. Speaking of circles, like the freaking C stick on it. It's like basically supposed to be what? The replacement for the Circle Pad Pro device that came out for the standard 3DS? I'm gonna go over here real quick just to see exactly where this is because I don't remember where it was. But yeah, the freaking C stick on the new 3DS. It's stupid. I don't know. I don't like it. I mean, I thought it was actually supposed to be a little bit more responsive than that. Unless I just got a broken one. I don't think I got a broken one. It works. It definitely works. But it just feels weird using it. Like, it's not doing what it's supposed to be. Like, I guess what I'm expecting when I use it, I expect it to work the similar. I expect it to work similarly to the actual circle pad on the left side of the 3DS. Oh my gosh, look at that. I don't know. It feels like it should work like that, but it doesn't. It just has this weird little drag to it, and it doesn't make any sense. Like, I don't even know, man. I have no idea. It's freaking weird. But I don't know. I haven't really tested it on any games either. I've only tested on the menu screen, so maybe it's actually better in-game? I doubt it. I mean, I could be wrong, but I honestly doubt it a little bit. I mean, for those of you who do have a new 3DS, or a new 3DS XL, what do you think about the C-Stick? I'm just curious about that. Because I just don't like it. I think it could have been made a little bit better. The Vol Forest Fog Shrouded Mystery. Well, this feels like another optional area that I could just be exploring right now, but I probably shouldn't be at the same time. I can't break this? Oh, wait. Oh, wait. No, what? Okay. Didn't expect that, I suppose. What's this? Oh, it's just cat spirits. Okay. So, can I actually go in here? Is this anything I can mess around with? No. Red fumes fills the air. It doesn't look like you can pass through like this. Okay, so I'm guessing I can't really do anything. There's that. Can't pass over that. I can go this way. Alright. Just for that, they're gonna freaking die for that. Jeez Louise. My god. Oh, hey, frame rate. No, don't do that, please. Would appreciate that. Seriously? I'm just like, hey. Mind my own business here. I'm like, oh, I'm just gonna have to scare you now. That literally freaking freaked me out right there. That's how I say words now. But seriously, though. What was that about? Like, I twisted my body in a weird way that kind of almost was making me feel that rib injury again. And I'm supposed to be over it! Like, I've hardly felt it at all over the last couple days here. And then suddenly that little scare is kind of just made me again. Just a little bit.
I wish I had power like that.
No, you don't, Isaac. No, you don't. Plundering ghosts!
Forget about it if I were you.
Oh, jeez. My gosh, that's amazing. I feel like I should put some different arts on. Cause I don't know. I have these two different wind arts. Like, yeah, I definitely should use something else. I feel like I should anyway. But oh, I forget how you do that. There's some way you can do that. Yeah, I mean, just look at how little I've used these arts here 20 times. I clearly do not like... Well, I don't like my X arts. I don't like my B arts. I don't know. I mean, I don't use Frigid Photon that often either, but I mean, considering how recent that is, I think this is something I've had since the beginning, isn't it? I don't even know. I gotta figure out how to use that stuff again. If I just, like, cancel my art and, like, hey, guess what? I'm gonna use the next upgrade thing. And then I could master that stuff and use whatever the heck I want to use. I thought I was gonna be an enemy. I was preparing myself, too. Arcane Bottle! So, great. Doesn't look like I can do anything here. I did just go that way, right? I don't even remember now. Yeah, there's nothing over there. So, yeah, nothing I can do here. I guess I'll just move on and then we'll go to the next location. And then, oh my gosh, no point using that either. No point wasting your materials for no reason at all. What was I saying? Something about the freaking circle pad or whatever, the C stick. Yeah, I just don't like it, personally. I haven't really tested it in the game yet, but I can't imagine it being that good. I really can't. I have seen on the... I've gone on Miiverse on the 3DS so far. And I have to say, it definitely does load faster. I heard that it was supposed to load faster because of it being more powerful because of that. It's kind of nice. I like it a little bit. I like that it loads faster. Because every now and then I do post some things on Miiverse. And if you ever are curious about that, I believe I have my Miiverse profile in the About section of my YouTube channel. If you're ever curious about that, maybe. Well, no, I can't say. Well, I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. If you're curious about it, go to my About section. Check out my Miiverse. Maybe you'll see some funny screenshots. Maybe you won't. I don't know. Maybe you'll see some weird screenshots. I don't necessarily have to be funny. I don't know. I post every now and then. And also from the 3DS. I've been mostly from the Wii U, but lately it's been 3DS just because I don't really have any new Wii U games to really mess around with. Maybe I will when the Switch gets Miiverse. I don't think it has Miiverse yet, does it? I don't know. Regardless, so whenever the Switch gets Miiverse, I'll no doubt be continuing posting Miiverse stuff from there, because that's fun. I don't know, I like doing it. It's fun to post Miiverse stuff. I know I had a lot of fun with Hyrule Warriors posting stuff from that. That was always fun. Fire Emblem Fates, I'm not really posting too much from that, but occasionally something just odd pops up. I'm like, hey, what the heck's up with that? Well, what is up with this? And I don't know, like, Odin will say something about the agonizing tomatoes. Like, hey, guess what? Wow, that's kind of weird. What the heck are you talking about tomatoes for? What are you, crazy, man? Of course you are. Just crazy stuff like that. I basically post something like that on Fates. And I try to avoid spoilers for the most part. And if I do, like, I use the spoiler tag. I don't post about that otherwise. No, it doesn't make any sense. I don't want to do that. All right. Open sesame. Enter. What we got here? Oh, jeez.
All right. If I were a Bloodwing, where would I be?
We'll start at the inn. It only makes sense.
I suppose so. I do suppose so. Well, do I talk to these people or do I not talk to these people? That is the question. We're basically at the end of the episode, too. Well, I don't know. We just got to a new town! What do you think? Do we do it now or do we do it later? Alright, you know what? Okay, here's what I'm gonna say right now. I will do a coin flip, sort of, not really. I'm gonna actually flip a card. If it's heads, I'll talk to one person. If it's tails, I will end the episode now and I'll leave you on a cliffhanger. Oh no. What could it be? You'll just have to believe me here. Alright, so the head side, I know what the head side and the tail sides are. It doesn't really matter if I say what it is, because you're not going to see it anyway. So just take my word for it. Heads, talk to one person. Tails, not one person. It's heads. Alright, we're talking to one person here. We'll talk to this person who's doing the stuff with the plants.
Raspberries, strawberries, blueberries.
Yum.
They all grow in abundance around Stonebury. We even have a fairy tale about it. One day, the ground was covered with so many fallen berries, they all became stones.
Stoneberries? Is that how the town got its name?
The spelling has changed some, but yes. Berries are an important part of this village. We harvest local berries to make jams, pastries, gels, and all sorts of sweets.
Berry-flavored gels! I've never had one.
We've exported our jam and fruit for a while now, but our raspberry gels are still being perfected.
Aw, rats!
Are the vegetables growing in that field special too? I don't think I've ever seen anything like them before.
You've got sharp eyes. But that's right. They're a rare species of wild potato. They're red and they're called radish bells. We discovered them in the mountains nearby. Sadly, the potatoes are actually highly poisonous.
Really? They look so good.
They do. But the skin and the sprouts are toxic. If you aren't careful when removing them, it's poisonville for you. Deadly poison aside, they're sweet, fluffy, and go great with butter. And when they're fried nice and crispy, they're the best.
So just skin them and sell them. What's the problem?
Yes, we've thought of that, but the way they are now, you have to peel off quite a bit before you get to the edible part. Peel one as big as your fist, and all you get for your trouble is a bit of meat the size of an egg yolk. That's why we're selectively breeding them. One day, they'll have only a thin layer of poisonous skin.
Why not breed them to get rid of the poison altogether?
With no poison, bugs will eat them, and they'll be more vulnerable to cold and heat. With potatoes, as with people, getting rid of everything harmful isn't always for the best.
Why would that affect cold and heat? That doesn't really make any sense to me. Also, I've had a bad experience with raspberry tails. Oh boy. Freaking Tales of Link. Gosh dang it. That spin-off game is stupid, by the way, but I just keep playing it for some reason. I don't know. I mean, it's not that. I guess it's not really that addicting. I mean, I play it every now and then, just when I'm just kind of bored and like, eh, whatever. Let's play something random for no reason. Like Fire Emblem Heroes is kind of just not holding my attention every now and then, or some other games that I'm playing. You're just like, eh, whatever. Maybe I'm charging my 3DS, so I'm not playing Fates at the moment. So, yeah, okay, great, whatever. So I'll just play freaking Tales of Link for no reason, and like, hey, I'll do this really difficult level. I'll do that really difficult level. I'll fight this freaking super boss who takes forever to get his freaking health down, but then when you get him down to half health, he uses a freaking raspberry gel that fully heals him, and then you're back to square one, and he'll freaking kill you in 2 hits, unless you get some lucky healing going on, and stuff like that, and he's like, oh, okay, great, oh my gosh, I love that. And then you get lucky for so long, where you make the battle last forever, and then he used another raspberry gel, it's like, ah. And then you get him down some more, and then you just keep being lucky. I was really getting lucky, honestly, and I'm talking from real experience here. There was one fight that I had difficulty with, but yeah. And then I got the health down some more, and then the freaking guy freezes literally everyone on my team. This is wrong. Everyone except for Colette. Thanks, Colette. You just had to be the only one who doesn't get frozen. If there was just a counter for freezing ability, that'd be great. I don't think there is a counter for freeze, is there? Anyone who's played Tales of Link, if you know if there's a counter for freeze, I would greatly appreciate that kind of knowledge, because, my gosh, that is like the one bane of my existence that I really can't seem to counter. It sucks. It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. I can't do anything about it. Anyway, though, that was the one person we talked to. Now we end the episode. We talk to the last 4 people next time, and then we go to the inn to look for blood wings, because that's what we want to do, obviously. So anyway, though, yeah, I will see you all later, everyone. And then this village is... Wait a second. I wonder if this village is at one location. Oh my gosh! No, no, this is the same location. This is the same... I think it is, isn't it? I don't know, actually. It might be. Oh, it's the Plague City, I think, from freaking Zestiria. I don't remember what it was called, but I think it's the same city. Maybe. I don't know. Wait, no! I don't know. It could be something, though. Anyway, whatever. I'll see y'all later, everyone. Bye!